The Keys to Hand Show. It's the Keys to Hand Show. I need a new theme for the Keys to Hand Show. You might hear news. You might learn stuff. You never know what you're going to get on the Keys to Hand Show. Wow. What's up, party people? It's your old pal, Keys Dan, from RadioWhat.com and DJLittleRock.com. And this is my podcast, The Keys Dan Show. Arr. It's an extension of the Keys Dan Enterprises, Entertainment, and Disc Jockeys that I've been running for quite some time. And if you'd like to tell your story, I encourage you to check out my other podcast, What Makes You Famous. Use the hashtag What Makes You Famous to find it everywhere. Now, on with the show. Boy, my voice is going to get hoarse if I keep talking like that. Party people, it's September 19th, and that is Talk Like a Pirate Day. International Talk Like a Pirate Day. International Talk Like a Pirate Day is a periodic holiday created in 1995 by John Barr, Old Chum Bucket, and Mark Summers, Captain Slappy, of Albany, Oregon, U.S., who proclaimed September 19 each year as the day when everyone in the world should talk like a pirate. An observer of this holiday would greet friends not with "Hello, everyone," but with "Ahoy, mateys," or "Ahoy, me hearties." The holiday and its observance springs from a romanticized view of the golden age of piracy. Here's the history of Talk Like a Pirate Day. According to Summers, the day is the only known holiday to come into being as a result of a sports injury. During a racquetball game between Summers and Barr, one of them reacted to the pain with an outburst of "Arr!" and the idea was born. That game took place on June 6, 1995, but out of respect for the observance of the Normandy landings, they chose Summers' ex-wife's birthday, as it would be easy for him to remember. At first, an inside joke between two friends, the holiday gained exposure when Barr and Summers sent a letter about their invented holiday to the American syndicated humor columnist Dave Barry in 2002. Barry liked the idea and promoted the day, and later appeared in a cameo in their "Drunken Sailor Sing Along a Go-Go" video, growling media coverage of the holiday after Barry's column has ensured that this event is now celebrated internationally, and Barr and Summers now sell books and t-shirts related to the theme on their website. Part of the success for the international spread of the holiday has been attributed to non-restriction of the idea or non-trademarking, in effect opening the holiday to creativity and viral growth. The association of pirates with peg legs, parrots, and treasure maps, popularized in Robert Louis Stevenson's novel Treasure Island, 1883, has had a significant influence on parody pirate culture. Talk Like a Pirate Day is celebrated with hidden Easter egg features in many games and websites, with Facebook introducing a pirate translated version of its website on Talk Like a Pirate Day 2008, and publisher O'Reilly discounting books on the R programming language to celebrate. In September 2014, Reddit added a pirate theme to their website. Linguistic background. English actor Robert Newton is the patron saint of Talk Like a Pirate Day. He portrayed pirates in several films, most notably Long John Silver, in both the 1950 Disney film Treasure Island and the 1954 Australian film Long John Silver, and the title character in the 1952 film Blackbeard the Pirate. Newton was born in Dorset and educated in Cornwall, and it was his native West Country dialect which he used in his portrayal of Long John Silver and Blackbeard that some contend is the origin of the standard pirate accent. This was parodied in the 1950s and 60s by British comedian Tony Hancock. the archetypal pirate word R, alternately R or Yar, which in West Country parlance means yes. This first appeared in fiction as early as 1934 in the film Treasure Island, starring Lionel Barrymore, and was used by a character in the 1940 novel Adam Penfeather, Buccaneer, by Jeffrey Farnell. However, it was Robert Newton's use of it in the classic 1950 Disney film Treasure Island that popularized the interjection and made it widely remembered. It has been speculated that the rolling R, a distinctive element of the speech of the West Country of England, has been associated with pirates because of the West Country's strong maritime heritage, where for many centuries fishing was the main industry and smuggling a major unofficial one, and where there were several major ports. As a result, West Country speech in general and Cornish speech in particular may have been a major influence on a generalized British nautical speech. That's a little bit about International Talk Like a Pirate Day, September 19th. This has been the Keys Dan Show. Arr. If you'd like to tell your story, I encourage you to check out my other podcast, What Makes You Famous. Find it everywhere using the hashtag What Makes You Famous. This has been Keys Dan. It's the Keys Dan Show. RadioWhat.com, DJLittleRock.com. Peace. I'm out of here. Arr. Arr. Ooh, that hurt my throat a little bit.